A very good morning, my dear students. So let's start with this lecture number 3 of unit 7, equilibrium. So I have already explained you that physical equilibrium and all that. What is that physical equilibrium? When it changes, equilibrium constant kya hota? So here also in this video also, we will learn something about equilibrium constant in details and types of equilibrium constant also. Okay. So let's start with the video with a very good quote, as I think that the way I see it, if you want the rainbow, you got to put up with the rain. That means, अगर सिंपल भाषा में कहें हम तो इसको ये मतलब है कि बच्चे अगर रेनबो का कलर चाहते हैं तो आपको बारिश से गुजरना पड़ेगा. तो सिंपली इफ यू वांट द गुड थिंग्स इन योर लाइफ ऑब्वियसली यू हैव टू स्ट्रगल फॉर दैट. ऑब्वियसली यू हैव टू गो थ्रू विद दैट द थिंग द वे यू हैव टू अचीव. लाइक इफ यू वांट टू अचीव एनीथिंग यू हैव टू वर्क फॉर दैट. सो इट इज अ वेरी गुड कोट एज आई थिंक. ओके सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद दिस क्लास एंड दैट वी कैन से दैट द लेक्चर. And that we are going to do that law of chemical equilibrium that is related with the law of mass action, which we have done in the previous video. Yes. So law of chemical equilibrium, it is just what it is. The law of mass action may be applied to a reversible reaction to derive the mathematical expression for the equilibrium constant. And that is called law of chemical equilibrium. Okay. So we know that mass action, law of mass action, it according to this, the rate of the rate constant for any reaction, the rate of the reaction depends upon the concentration of reactant only. It is directly proportional to concentration of reactant. And whenever we remove a proportionality sign, we put a constant. And since we talk about the equilibrium at the equilibrium, so that's why we say that this constant is called equilibrium constant. Yes. So I will repeat that on that line also and that thing also. Let us consider a simple reversible reaction, that is A plus B change into C plus D. So if we talk about the forward reaction, in this case, the reactant will be A and B. But if we will talk about the backward reaction, the reactant will change, like the reactant will be C and D. Yes. So if I am considering the forward reaction in which the equilibrium exists between the reactant A and B and the product C and D, the forward and the backward reactions are A plus B change into C plus D and C plus D change into A plus B respectively. I must write over here respectively. Okay. So now next thing, according to the law of mass action, rate of forward reaction is directly proportional to concentration of A and concentration of B. Yes. And if we remove the proportionality sign, we put a constant. And since it is for forward reaction, so I will mention it with a KF. F for forward reaction. Similarly, for backward reaction, the reactant will be C and D. So, the rate of reaction will be directly proportional to concentration of C and concentration of D. So, since again, whenever I will remove this proportionality sign, we put a constant. And since this reaction is for backward reaction, so I will mention it with the KB. I hope it is clear. And we know that at the equilibrium, rate of forward reaction is equal to rate of backward reaction. So, what next we can say that? We can say that this KF, these two are equal. So that means KF AB concentration will be equal to KB concentration of C and D. So that's the same I have done over here. Now, KF upon KB. If I'm doing this KF upon KB, what it will be? Concentration of product upon concentration of reactant, isn't it? So this is constant, this is constant. So another constant for these two constant I'm going to give you, and that is K equilibrium. Okay. That is K equilibrium, concentration of C into concentration of D, or we can say simply say that K equilibrium will be equal to concentration of product upon concentration of reactants. Yes. Writing equilibrium constant. How to write like for a general reaction like A, B, B, C, C, D, D. Like this A, B, C, D, small a, small b, C, and D. These are the stoichiometric coefficient. So these stoichiometric coefficient will be converted into its power. Okay. So for this reaction, the equilibrium constant may be represented as like K equilibrium will be the concentration of product, that is C, and whatever the stoichiometric coefficient, that will be converted into the power. Similarly, D, power D, and this is concentration of A, concentration of B, power B. I hope it is clear. So for another example, if I'm saying this 4NH3 plus 5O2, 4NO plus 6H2O. So these are the product. Yes. And these are the reactants. So what we will do first, if I will write the reactant equilibrium constant, then first we will write the product यानी कि के इक्विलिब्रियम विल बी कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ ईच प्रोडक्ट दैट इज एनओ एंड स्टोइकोमेट्रिक कोएफिशिएंट इज 4 सो वी विल मेक इट पावर 4 H2O पावर 6 सिमिलरली रिएक्टेंट विल बी देयर एज अ व्हाट वी से डिनोमिनेटर सो NH3 एंड दैट विल बी द पावर 4 O2 पावर 5 होप इट इज क्लियर Since it is in terms of concentration, so this K equilibrium can also be mentioned as KC. Equilibrium constant in terms of concentration, so that we can say KC. Yes, and that also that I have already mentioned in the previous class also. Now the equilibrium constant, it is the how we can define this equilibrium constant. It is the ratio between the product of molar concentration of products to the molar concentration of the reactant. It is the ratio between the product of molar concentration of products to the molar concentration of reactant. With each concentration termed raised to the power equal to its stoichiometric coefficient. In a balanced chemical equation at a constant temperature. I hope it is clear. Yes, never it will be asked. The definition will never be asked. But yeah, of course it will be asked that write the equilibrium constant for the following equation. So for that you should know the stoichiometric coefficient also plays an important role and that will be converted into its power. Now equilibrium constant in gaseous state. So gaseous state doesn't have concentration, they have pressure. Yes. So in gaseous system, the concentration of gases may also be expressed in terms of their partial pressure. In general, it is mentioned in terms of partial pressure only. Yes, we can convert this into concentration by the equation, ideal gas equation. Yes. So, but in general, it is always mentioned in the terms of partial pressure. For a gaseous reaction like AAP, BB, CC, D. So here we will not write the concentration. Here what we will write? P. Pressure, partial pressure. Yes. So equilibrium constant may be represented as this P denotes as pressure. So pressure of concentration of C and whatever the stoichiometric coefficient that will be converted into as a power. Similarly, pressure of D power D, pressure of A power A, pressure of B power B. Clear? Any doubt in this? Yes. So, where PA, PB, PC and PD are the partial pressure of the gas A, B, C, D respectively. And since this equilibrium constant, first I should write equilibrium, K equilibrium, we can write here. Let me write here K equilibrium. And since this K equilibrium is mentioned in terms of pressure, so it can be mentioned as KP. To be very clear, to be very like... to differentiate these two equilibrium constant, we can say that since that was in terms of concentration, so we have mentioned with the KC, and here it is in terms of pressure, so we will mention with the KP. Yes, it's not like that ki KP and KC will always be equilibrium. It's not like that. It may differ, and there is a particular relation between that I'm going to prove you for you people. Yes. Note. Equilibrium constant K has no unit as it is the unit of concentration only, sorry, ratio of concentration. So both are concentration. So that's why it has no unit. Okay. Dimensionless if the total number of moles of the product is exactly equal to total number of reactants. In that case only where the stoichiometric coefficient of reactants and the stoichiometric coefficient of products are same, then there will be no unit. But if they vary, obviously, something will left and it must have some unit. Okay. On the other hand, if the number of moles of product and reactants are not equal, then only the K has specific unit. As for example, let me show you like H2 gas plus I2 gas change into 2HI. So, in this case, that reactant coefficient 1 and 1, 2 and product coefficient 2. So, that means there will be no unit for KP and KC. Yes. But in this reaction, like N2O4 change into 2NO2. So, for the reactant, there is no stoichiometric coefficient. That means we can say 1. For the this product, there is a 2 concentration, 2 stoichiometric coefficient. So, obviously, KC will have some unit. What unit? Like we know that KC is equal to concentration of product. So, product concentration, if I am writing, and that is the power 2. And this is the reactant concentration. And there will be power 1, isn't it? So, concentration unit, we know that mole per liter. So, this will be power 2 and here only mole per liter. So, what will be the unit left? This will be cancelled. So, here in this case, the KC will have unit that is mole per liter. Similarly, KP ki baat karenge, to bar bach jayega. Yes. बार एटीएम व्हाटएवर जो भी पास्कल जिस भी मेरी पार्शियल प्रेशर गिवन है वो यूनिट बच जाएगी. सो आई होप इट इज क्लियर. यस, व्हेन इट विल हैव यूनिट, व्हेन इट विल नॉट हैव यूनिट. सो लेट्स डू सम क्वेश्चन, एंड दीज आर द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन एंड वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन but tricky as well, and many times it is asked in your entrance exams. Okay, so let's do this question. For reaction 2a plus b change into 2c, the equilibrium constant is x. What will be the equilibrium constant for c change into a plus half b? So what you have to do, first you have to write kc for this equation jo given hai, uske liye aap k ki value likho. So k equilibrium, agar kc I will write, the product is c, it should be big parenthesis, and there is a power 2 sim upon a power 2 and b. Okay, let me write like this. So this is, and now if I will write for this equation, this is k1, you can say mention it k1. Okay, now k2 write down. K2 will be what? This is the concentration, the product is now a, so let it be a, and then b power half, and then what? C. So now check this, K1 and K2 mein what is the relation? This is quite clear that K1 is inversely proportional to is reverse of K2, because jo yahan pe reactant hai wo idhar product hai, jo product hai wo reactant hai. So this is going to be for sure, isn't it? Now check what other relation it is having. So see, if I will do this K2, if I will do K2 ka square agar hum kar dete hain, suppose that this K2, I'm doing this is here. If I will do this square for this, agar hum K2 ka square kar dete hain, so what I will get? I will get this A square, this is B upon C square, isn't it? So then it is going to be equal, or like reverse equal. So we can say that K1 is equal to 1 upon K2. So what is the relation over here? Now aap se K2 pucha ja raha. So K2 will be what? 1 upon K1 reverse. Under root, isn't it? We can say. So this is 1 upon root under x. K1 is given x. So this is the answer. What? Answer 3 is the correct answer. Got it? Any doubt in this? In this question, the following equilibria are given. N2 plus 3H2 change into 2NH3. So just what you have to do, you just separately write for everyone. K1, what it will be? K1 is NH3 power 2 upon N2 and H2 power 3. Yes, let me write. Now K2 write down. K2 is equal to NO. This is going to be power 2 upon N2 and then O2. Now write down for K3. K3 is H2O upon H2 and O2 power half. Yes, okay. So the question is next, that for the reaction 2, NH3 plus 5O2 change into this in terms of kya hoga. So let me write, this is the equation final, K final. So let me write, it is a K final. Or any other name you can give, K4, K naam de sakte kuch bhi. So for this, NO power 2, H2O power 3 upon NH3 power 2 and O2 power 5 by 2. Yes. So what you have to do now, you just think of it and decide that how I will get this is NO, concentration of NO, from where we will get this concentration of NO power 2, that I can get it from here. Yes, clear. So that means K2 should be as a numerator, clear. K2, NO power 2 is there. And this NO power 2 is there. Let it be. Now this is K3, H2O. H2O is here. So this one is, I required H2O. But it should be what? This is 3 over here. Power is 3. But here it is 1. So what I will do? I will do that K3 power 3. Can I do? I want this equation. By, is this a solve karo this equation. This 3, 1, you have to solve so that you will get this one. Okay? Chalo. Now, next is NH3. NH3 we can get it from here. Yes, and NH3 we want power 2, and NH3 power 2 is here, so let it be, and just make it K1 over here. Now put the value and check this, whether I'm getting this one or not. So K2 is given here, yani ki NO power 2 upon N2, then O2. Yes, this is K2 done. K3. K3 is H2O power 3 upon H2 power 3 and O2 power 3 by 2. Yes, end it out. Okay, now I want upon K1. So K1 is here. That means NH3 is going to be here. NH3 here, and this is power 2. And this, whatever the denominator over here, that will go up. And this will be N2 and H2 power 3. End it out. Now just cut this. Okay. So this is, see, NO2, this is H2 whole 3. Okay, N2 here, N2, H2 power 3, H2 power 3. And NH3, okay, nothing is going to, now just write down whatever you is left over here. So we are getting NO2 power 2, yes, H2O power 3, okay, upon what you get, you are getting NH3 power 2. So let it be NH3 power 2, and oxygen over here 1, and here oxygen 3 by 2. So what it will be? Oxygen 5 by 2, isn't it? And that is the thing, you got it here. So that means K final is equal to what? K final is equal to K2, K3 power 3 upon K1. Yes, check this, which one is the answer? K2, K3 power 1, and this one is the answer. Let me use another color, otherwise it will not be visible. Yes, clear? Got it? Okay, so this way we got it. If I will tell you, to how you have solved, just give the explanation. So that is the way you have. Another way, if it is asked in the MCQ, you can answer it very quickly to see that in this case NH3 is in the reactant. Yes, NH3 is in the reactant. So just check NH3 where it can, if I will write NH3 here, it is reactant. That means then in the final equation, the K1 should be, NH3 should be as a denominator. So just check where I will get that, how I will put this K1, K2, K3 so that NH3 will be as a denominator. So obviously this K1 is having NH3, and here it is product. So this K1 should be as a denominator, then only this NH3 come as a denominator. So there is no other option in which the K1 is as a denominator. So that way also you can answer it quickly. But phir bhi, just for verification, you have to solve this and you have to understand that how it will be, whether it is correct or not. So you have to check this. Okay. So now move to next question. And that is the next question. K1 and K2 are respective equilibrium constant for the two reaction. XeF6 plus H2O, this is, okay. So since it is in pressure gas term, so let me use the KP word and pressure word. Okay, so KP word mention karne ki zarurat nahi because it is given K1. So let it be K1, but pressure ke term mein hum karenge. So we will say that pressure XeOF4. Yes, pressure of HF. Yes, and that is going to be power 2. Yes, upon pressure of XeF6 upon pressure of H2O. Clear? Similarly, we will write for K2, and that if we'll write for K2, we will get that pressure of XeOF4, then pressure of XeO3F2, and then pressure of XeO4, and then pressure of XeF6. Yes. Now, you have another equation, and for this the equilibrium constant is asked. So suppose that this equation, for this equation, the equilibrium constant K. Okay. So for what, for this, what you will write that pressure of XeO3F2, pressure of H2O upon pressure of XeO4 and pressure of HF power 2. Yes, you will write that. So this is the desired one. we want it, yes. Now we have to solve this k1 and k2 in such a way so that I will get this this value k. Okay, so just check this, that I want k mein, what we need, k xe o3 f2 I want as a numerator. So in this way, if I will keep this k2 as a numerator, I will get xe o3 f2 as a numerator, yes. And what next? HF should be, HF is here na, HF should be as a denominator. So that means K1 ko agar hum denominator mein karte hain, so we will get like this. Clear? Baki dekho, sab power and all that are same. So just doing this K2 upon K1, you will get this K value. Got it? So just answer is K2 upon K1 is this D answer. I hope it is clear. Yes? Let's move to next question. Next heading is relation between KP and KC. That is going to be a very important topic, and sometime the derivation will also be asked from this. So what is the relation between KP and KC? Here they are showing the relation. So let's start with this. I'm going to start for this equation. Suppose that the equation A, this is A equation, assume kar lete, okay? So this is CC plus D and D. Clear? So if I will write KC for this, what I will write? I will write like concentration of C power C, concentration of D power D upon concentration of A power A and concentration of B power B. Clear? There is no doubt in this? Okay. Now, if I will write KP for this equation, for the same, suppose that they have partial pressure also. If I will write KP for this, what I will write? I will write PC power C, PD power D, PA power A, and PB power B. Yes? Okay. So now, what is the relation between these two? So let me explain for you people. So this is, we know that PV is equal to kya hota hai? NRT. Clear? This is the ideal gas equation, we know that. So in this case, if I will keep this like N by V I will take, then what it will be? P upon RT? Yes or no? And N by V is equal, called as concentration. And the concentration we will explain, and instead of writing full concentration C O N C, I will just mark it with this. Yes? Like concentration of A, I will write like this, concentration of A. Any doubt? Clear? So this will be equal to P upon RT. There's no problem at all. Okay. So let's write this. Now in this KP, KC, concentration of CC, can I write like this? Concentration of C power C, can I write like this? P upon RT. And this is C. Similarly, P D upon RT D, and this will be P A RT power A and P B RT B. Any problem in this? Can I write like this? Yes. So chalo, next isi equation ko I'm just writing in this way, P C power C, then PD power D, and then PA power A, and then PB power B into what upon this 1 upon RT, here it is left now, 1 upon RT C, 1 upon RT D. Yes, so just I'm doing shortcut little, and can I write like this? See, this is base are same, so power will be added. Yes. So can I write like this? C plus D. Can I say? Similarly, 1 upon RT and this will be A plus B. Isn't it? So now this is like limit. Okay. So here, instead of this part, ye pure part ki jagah pe. This is equal to KC. Ye KC ke equal chal raha, okay? So, can I write like this? KC is equal to, instead of this whole part, I will write KP. Because, see? Yes? So Kp, and what is this? If base are same, then power will be in this, since they are in division, so we can say subtract. So can I write like this? 1 upon RT, and this will be C plus D minus A plus B. Yes? Okay, so what is the C plus D and minus A? C plus D, that means moles of product. Yes? C plus D, moles of product. Or A plus B, moles of reactant. So I can write for this, instead of this, delta N, which shows the number of moles of product minus number of moles of reactant. So this will be equal to C plus D minus A plus B. Yes. So further, I can write like this. Kc is equal to Kp upon RT, RT power delta N. Yes. Or finally, we will get an equation, that is a relation. We can say that it is Kp is equal to Kc RT delta N. So this is the relation between Kp and Kc. Okay. Any doubt in this? So this is the relation between Kp and Kc. Now, this is the derivation. This derivation can be asked. Okay. So here is that symbolic form. I have written that Kp is equal to Kc RT delta N, or Kc is equal to Kp upon RT delta. Kp power, maybe it is minus negative of minus M. Okay. So delta N is equal to number of gases product minus number of gases reactant. So it can be said as delta Ng also. Okay. For the reaction in which equal number of moles of gases appear on both sides on the reaction, then the delta N will be equal to zero. And in that case, Kp will be equal to Kc, because we know that anything power zero will be considered as one. For the gases phase reaction, we can calculate the amounts of substance present at equilibrium using either Kp or Kc. That equilibrium pe, what is the amount of the reactant and the product, we can calculate easily by using Kp and Kc. The results are same by either method. Jo bhi use karo, either Kp use karo or Kc use karo, you will get the same result. There is no issue. But yes, of course, the unit will be different. Kp, if you will find, it will be in the terms of pressure, and bar unit will be there, or something atm unit will be there, or related with the pressure. If you will use Kc, it will give you the concentration terms. Okay. Now here is a question related between which is related to Kp and Kc. So Kp is how many times equal to Kc for the reaction? So just find this. If I will say this, this is a formula. We know that. One second. We know the formula. Kp is equal to Kc RT delta N. Yes, RT power delta N. So just find the delta N for this. Delta N is equal to gaseous product, yani ki 2 minus gaseous reactant, yani 1 plus 3. That means it is going to be 2 minus 4, yani minus 2. So what will be the answer? Kp is equal to Kc, and RT, that is going to be power minus 2. So it can be written Kp is equal to Kc upon RT power 2. So the answer is, it is asked that how many Kp is how many times equal to this. That means 1 upon R square T square. Yes. So this is the answer. Clear? Any problem in this? Okay. We can write now. Kp is equal to like this. Kp is equal to Kc, and this is 1 upon R square T square, I can write. So this much time. It is than the Kc, it is Kp. Yes. Okay. So as the next question, it is at 700 Kelvin, the equilibrium constant Kp for the reaction. This is for the reaction 2SO3 gas change into 2SO2 gas plus O2 gas. And that is, this value is given for Kc for the equation. And what is the numerical value? Don't be confused with this mole per liter, mole per decimeter cube. What it is. See, obviously this is in that product side, you can see that 2 plus 1, 3, and reactant side 1. So obviously that equilibrium constant will have some unit, isn't it? So this is 1 liter is equal to decimeter cube. So that is the mole per liter you have to find for of Kc for the reaction at the same temperature. So there is the Kp and Kc relation, you find it. And delta Ng you can find, like this is 2 plus 1 product minus 2. So delta Ng is 1, isn't it? And T value is given 700 Kelvin, R value 8.314 joule per Kelvin per mole. Yes, joule per Kelvin per mole hota hai. So there is per Kelvin per mole, okay? So Kp is given this. So to solve it, obviously we are supposed to convert this in the same unit. So kilopascal, it is this kilopascal. So I can say 10 to the power 3 se multiply karke, we can convert it into Pascal. And Pascal is equal to Newton meter per square. This is, so we can say that 1.8 in Newton meter per square, isn't it? So that is the value I have written over here. And then 8.314 joule per Kelvin per mole, and 700 is Kelvin. Kelvin will be cancelled out. And then Newton meter square. So just convert this Newton meter square. Newton ko convert karo. So so that this joule will be cancelled. And all this cancellation will be there. And then it will give you 3.09 to 10 per minus 4 mole per meter cube. So since we want the unit in decimeter cube, so obviously we have to convert this meter cube into decimeter. And for this, what we'll do, 1 meter cube will be 10 to the power minus 3 decimeter. So just put this, multiply karo, and then you will get this 10 to the power minus 7 mole per decimeter cube. Clear? Okay. So now the next question is PCl5, PCl3 and Cl2 at equilibrium. At 500 Kelvin, having concentration, this means this is the concentration at the equilibrium given, okay, 1.59 molar PCl3, 1.59 Cl2 and 1.41 molar PCl5. So equilibrium concentration is given, you have to find. So this is the equation PCl5, obviously that formula we know that equilibrium constant is equal to product concentration of product upon concentration of reactant. This is PCl3 concentration. It is given over 1.59. Cl2 concentration 1.59. And PCl5 is given 1.41. Just put the value and solve it. You will get this 1.79 molar. Yes, that equilibrium concentration will be that molar ko ho. Ya phir 1.79 mole per liter. Both are the same thing. Okay. So let's move to next question. And here is the next question that determine Kc for the reaction, and that Kp is given over here. Okay, Kp is given over here, 3.4 bar. Temperature is given. So just find the delta Ng in this case. Delta Ng will be gaseous product is 2 and reactant is 2 plus 1. That means it is going to be minus 1. So we know the formula that Kp is equal to Kc RT delta N. Yes. So RT delta N is minus 1 over here. So we can write that Kc upon RT. But Kp is there. So we want Kc. So Kc is equal to Kp into RT. Yes. Now just put the value and get the answer. So Kp is, let me explain it here. Space is less over there. So okay, so Kc is equal to Kp ki value 3.4 bar inverse is given. R ki value, since it is in bar, so we have to take the bar unit, and that is 0.083 bar liter per Kelvin per mole unit is there, and the temperature is 1000 degrees Celsius. So convert it into Kelvin, so it will be 1273, isn't it, Kelvin. So what will happen, this Kelvin will cancel. Yes, so let me, this Kelvin per Kelvin is there, cancelled. This bar and per bar is cancelled. So what is the answer left? That is 3.4 into 0.083 into 1273. And just calculate it. Calculation, it will give you 359.24. Okay. And what unit is left? Unit is left here per mole liter. So per mole liter will be the unit left for the Kc. Got it? I hope it is clear. So this question, in this question Kc is given and Kp you have to find. So this is homework. Do it. Okay. Now move to next question. The next question is that an equilibrium system for the reaction between hydrogen and iodine to give hydrogen iodide at 670 Kelvin in 5-liter flask contains 0.4 mole per mole of hydrogen and 0.4 mole of iodine, 2.4 mole of hydrogen iodide. So you have to find the equilibrium constant. This is the homework. I'm just giving you a hint over here. First, you write the equation. Okay, this is concentration I have not given. I have given mole. So what you have to do, you have to find with this the mole and the volume is given over here. So by this, you find the calculation, that concentration. Okay, and then you have to find the equilibrium. This will be, see, an equilibrium system for the reaction between hydrogen and iodine is, that means it makes your work easy. That means it is going to be on equilibrium. So whatever the concentration you will find, that will be at the equilibrium. And then you just put this Kc is equal to what? H2Hi and then H2 concentration and then I2 concentration. I hope you can get it easily. The only thing is that it is not concentration, mole per liter. You have to find the calculation, concentration. Got it? Okay. So that's it for today, class. I hope you got it. And the relation, whatever I have explained about the Kp and Kc, that it is clear to you. So just practice the questions I have given to homework. You do it. And next we will discuss about the other type of equilibrium and the reaction quotient. So that we will do in the next video. Till then, thank you, class.